In this video, we will be looking at some more relations for expectation and covariance. These are slightly advanced relations. We will be using this only rarely in the course. So, in case you do not understand this portion, that is okay. You will get to understand it a little better as the course progresses. So, please do not panic in case it looks a little bit unfamiliar to you. So, we had looked at the variance for a single vector, variance of x vector. Now, we are going to look at the covariance of two vectors. So, remember that for scalar functions f of x and g of y, we had defined the covariance as the deviation from the expectation of f of x multiplied by the deviation from the expectation of g of y and expectation of the whole thing. Okay. You might also remember that the simpler definition was that of simple x and y, and that definition is given here. Finally, we had looked at covariance of two vectors. Okay. This can be called as the variance. Remember, just like covariance of xx is called variance of x, okay, which is the square of the standard deviation. Okay. Now, we had defined something called the covariance matrix. This was a matrix of all covariances. You can recollect this from the previous video. This is simply a matrix of covariance of, let us say, the first element will be covariance of x 1 and x 1, so on and so forth. Remember, x is a vector and x I is the ith component of the vector x. Okay. Now, let us say we denote by mu. This is standard notation. Mean or expectation is denoted by mu. Let us say mu is the expectation of the vector x, and since it is a vector, mu is also going to be a vector. Again, if you look at the previous videos, you will see that the first element of mu 1 is the first element of the expectation, so on and so forth. It is a full vector. Okay, so, let us say mu is the expectation of the random vector x, then covariance of x comma x, which we have seen before, okay, can be written as x minus mu times x minus mu transpose. This is the way that we had defined it before. Okay. So, covariance of x simply by extending this is x minus mu. Remember, now x is a vector, x minus mu is also a vector, and you are taking a transpose. Okay. Why are we taking a transpose? What is the size of this? This is a n cross 1 vector. Suppose I take a transpose, this is 1 cross n. Therefore, what you will get is, I have written m cross m. So, this should be m and this can be m also. Okay. So, covariance of x comma x can now be defined in this way: expectation of xx transpose minus expectation of x multiplied by expectation of x transpose. Okay. Remember this, if x is a scalar, this simply comes to expectation of x square minus expectation of x the whole square. Okay. This we have seen before also. As I said before, we use the notation that variance of x is equal to covariance of x comma x. Okay. Now, similarly, just very, very similar to this idea, we can now define covariance of x comma y. Now, let us say x is an R m, okay, that is, and y belongs to R n, which means that x is now a m cross 1 vector, y is a n cross 1 vector. So, y transpose is now 1 cross n. Okay. So, we would write, instead of x x transpose, you would write expectation of x y transpose minus expectation of x multiplied by expectation of y transpose. This is simply a definition. This is just the way we define covariance of x comma y. You can show easily that covariance of x comma y is the same as covariance of y comma x the whole transpose. I would suggest that you try this as a exercise. Now, another idea that we are going to look at is the sums of two random variables. Remember that we had already discussed that the expectation is a linear operator, so that if you have expectation of alpha g plus beta h, it is going to be alpha times expectation g plus beta times expectation h. Now, we are going to extend this idea to that of two random variables, two different random variables, let us say x and y, both are now of the same size n cross 1. Then we know that since expectation is linear, expectation of x plus y is simply going to be expectation of x plus expectation of y. Similarly, expectation of alpha x plus beta y is going to be alpha times expectation x plus beta times expectation y. Variances, however, behave slightly more differently. Okay. So, variation of x plus y, variance of x plus y is not simply variance of x plus variance of y, you have these two additional terms as well. Okay. You have these covariance terms, covariance of x comma y and covariance of y comma x. Okay. So, these two are not equal, they are the transposes of each other. If you take variance of alpha x, this should be alpha square here, I am sorry, it is alpha square times variance of x. Now, notice that if x and y are independent, okay, if x and y are independent, we had this discussion in an earlier slide that if x and y are independent, then covariance of xy is 0. Similarly, covariance of yx is also 0. Okay. So, this gives only under the condition that x and y are independent do we get that variance of x plus y is variance of x plus variance of y. Okay. Now, as an exercise, please think about what happens to variance of x minus y. Okay. So, if you combine these two relationships, I will again suggest this as an exercise, I will give you the final expression. So, variance of x minus y will be variance of x plus variance of y, notice the plus, it is not minus, minus covariance of x y minus covariance of y x. Again, I would suggest this as a quick exercise for you to try out. Okay. If you ignore the minus parts, minus covariance x, y, etcetera, notice that even if you have the difference of two variables, the errors will still add. Okay. Variance is like the error, okay. It is like the variation. You would have seen this in simple, you know, experimental measurements perhaps a little bit before, that if I have two variables, you know, I make one length minus another length, it does not mean that the errors subtract, the errors still add, because the errors go as the variance. Okay. So, therefore, the errors add here. Okay. The final idea that I would like to discuss in this video is that of an affine transformation. An affine transformation is nothing but another name for a linear transformation. So, let us say you have two random variables or two variables x and y, x is a vector, y is a vector, A is a matrix. Okay. You can transform, y can be seen as x with a linear transform, B is also a vector here of course, in order for our dimensions to match. Okay. So, x is a vector, B is a vector, A is a matrix and y is another vector. So, y is Ax plus b. Now, if I have this, suppose I know the mean of x or suppose I know the variance of x, can I find out the mean and variance of y? It turns out that there are mathematical relationships. Expectation works out as we expect. Okay. So, expectation of y, we will just write the the expressions here. Please notice this, the subscript, this expectation is over the variable y, this expectation is over the variable x. Okay. So, expectation of y is expectation of Ax plus b, which since expectation is linear, you simply take out A, which is a constant matrix outside, A times expectation x plus b, mu of course is the notation for expectation of x. Okay. So, this is quite simple as far as expectation is concerned. Now, variance, we will go through this slowly, is once again slightly more involved. Okay. Let us look at it step by step. So, variance of y is, of course, y is defined as ax plus b, so this is fine. Variance of ax plus b is the same as variance of x because variance of something x plus a constant is the same as variance of x. Why is that? You can prove this very easily mathematically, but let us just look at it very simply from a physical point of view. Variance measures the difference from the mean, okay, or the distance from the mean. If I change the variable by a constant, the mean will also go up by a constant and that constant subtracts out. We are only looking at difference from the mean and we are not looking at the actual value of the variable. Okay, since that is the case, so whether I add b or not, I am going to get the same variance. Okay. Now, variance of ax was defined as covariance of the variable with itself, ax, ax. Now, we can write it out based on the definition that we had earlier. Remember that covariance of a variable with itself was expectation of yy transpose minus expectation of y expectation of y transpose. That is what is used here. Okay, instead of y I have ax, ax, ax transpose, ax expectation of ax transpose. Okay. Now, we can open this up noting the fact that ax transpose is the same as x transpose a transpose. So, that is opened up here. Now, also I have used the fact that expectation of ax is a times expectation of x. Similarly, expectation of ax transpose is the same as expectation of x transpose a transpose, which is the same as expectation of x transpose multiplied by a transpose. That is what is used here. Now, I can bring out a from the front end and bring out a transpose from the back end. Okay. So, we can do that. So, a from the front end, a transpose from the back end, and we can take that out common and you get a times expectation of x x transpose minus expectation of x transpose, and a transpose comes out. So, you can now rewrite it. This is nothing but covariance of x comma x, which we discussed in the previous slide. So, a times covariance of x x x comma x a transpose. Typically, the covariance matrix is denoted by sigma, just like mu is the expectation of x, capital sigma is the variance of x, which is the same as covariance of x comma x. So, we have looked at a lot of mathematical relations in this video. As I said earlier, you might or might not be comfortable with it. Even if you are not comfortable with it, we do not use at least this set of expressions too often, but please get comfortable by watching this a few times in case you found it unfamiliar. We will use it a little bit towards the later half of the course. Thank you.